This is version 2, sort of my homemade loop station. I made the first version in 2021, and the instructions from the video I made at that time don't work anymore because of the changes in the operating system and so on. This is an updated version. I have updated the code. The reason it sort of stopped working is because I did a lot of things in kind of hacky ways, and I've tried to do fewer things in hacky ways now, but you know, there's still a bit of hackiness in there. But again, it does work right now. So in addition to just making it work, I added one feature which I always found myself wanting in this thing, and that's the ability to undo the latest overdub. And so I'll just show you how that works. So I added a layer to the first track there. Now if I hold the record button here, that's gonna go away. Right? Holding the record button used to clear the track, and the way to do that now, so if I just like record a bogus track over here, the way to get rid of that is I first mute the playback, I press the play button, and then I hold this down, and now it's gone. So I'll jam for a couple more minutes maybe, and then you can see how this works. And after that, I'll show you how to do the software setup and how, you know, how that's different from last time. And for the hardware part of things, just go to my old video. Everything is exactly the same and all of that will still work. Alright, and if you want to skip to the software setup and skip past this jam, you can do that. Here's the timestamp.
The setup for this looper on the software side of things is actually easier now than it was in 2021, and this is just because things have gotten more streamlined over time and I've improved the code and so on. Just like in the first version, there are some things that you need to do before you can follow the steps I'm about to show you here, and those are: first, you need to install the Raspberry Pi operating system or an SD card. You need to boot into that SD card on your Raspberry Pi. And then you need to open a Linux terminal on your Raspberry Pi. Now you can do this either using keyboard, mouse, monitor, a physical setup, or using SSH as I am doing here. However you decide to do that, the first command you're going to want to run is sudo apt install python 3 PyAudio to install a Python library called PyAudio, which my code uses, and this is going to do that. And I have found that apt is generally the best way to install this. The next thing is to uninstall false audio. So sudo apt, and I'm going to say remove pulse audio. So pulse audio is a kind of high level audio software on Linux, and from what I understand, what it does is it mixes together different application audios. So if you have a browser playing some sound and a music player playing some sound, it's going to be Pulse that's going to mix those together for you to, you know, listen to both of them simultaneously. The thing is, we don't actually need Pulse audio for the looper, because I have mixing code built into it, and also Pulse audio sometimes actually interferes with the looper and makes it difficult to get access to the sound card and so on. And so this is why Pulse audio should be uninstalled. And what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to run this command twice, because I ran it once and there was something left over in terms of some kind of configuration, but when I ran it a second time, everything seemed to be fine. So I'm just doing it to make sure that I can replicate that good result. So now that Pi Audio is installed and Pulse Audio is uninstalled, I can go ahead and actually download the looper code. So this can be done using git clone https://github.com/randomvertebrate, which is my GitHub name, /raspi looper, like this. And this is going to download the entire repository for me, and that's done. Now I'm going to go ahead and change directory into this repository directory. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to run a script called devices.py, like that. And what this script is going to do is it is going to scan all the audio devices available on the Raspberry Pi, and it is going to tell me which indices the Raspberry Pi and Pi Audio in particular actually associates with those. So the index for our USB audio device is 1, and we know that now, so we can go on to the next step, which is running this script called settings.py, so Python 3 settings.py. And what this is going to do is going to ask a bunch of questions about the kind of audio that you want to use. So I'm going to put in 44.1 kilohertz for the sample rate, which is a safe choice for most sound cards. I'm going to put in 512 for the buffer size, which seems to work from experience. Now, if you find issues with glitchy audio, you can try increasing this value to 1024. I'm going to put in the device index as 1, not 0, and the output device index is the same. And then the latency, the margin for late button press in milliseconds. This is how long after you actually want to stop recording a track are you allowed to stop recording. You know, how much of an allowance for a late button press to stop recording are you giving yourself so that it still quantizes to the length that you originally intended. And that is 500 is the value I'm going to put in for that, because again, it seems to work fine. So at this point, essentially, the looper can be run by running the script Python 3 main.py. So if I say Python 3 main.py and run this command, at this point I can start looping. However, that's not how I want to do this. I want the looper to automatically run the script when it boots up. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit this file called rc.local, like this. And this is a terminal script that is executed every time the Pi boots up, as far as I understand. In the previous version, I used a file called .bashrc, which I think executes when you actually log on. So this is a better approach, although, you know, that one does work as well. And I'm going to add two lines of code to the end of this file, right before exit 0. And so these lines are going to be executed every time the Pi boots up. And the lines I want to add are, first, change directory into our code directory, and the next one is going to be sudo python 3 main.py. Essentially, run the looper script. And the reason I'm running this as sudo is because sometimes if you don't run it as sudo, your script doesn't get access to the sound card if something else is currently accessing it. So running it as sudo makes sure that it always starts up. So now I'm going to press Control X to exit this. I'm going to press Y to save, and I'm going to press Enter and not change the file name. So at this point, technically, the Raspberry Pi is set up as a looper, and if you restart it, you can loop with it. However, there are a few additional, I suppose, optional steps that you can take to kind of improve the performance just a little bit more. So the first would be to adjust the sound levels, and you can do this using Alza Mixer, like this. And when you go in here, you find a page like this, and if you press F6, that shows you a list of all the audio devices available. You can use the arrow keys to scroll down to USB audio device. And when I press Enter, I see this screen here, and I can see that my levels are quite low. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just increase the levels to just under the red, because I'm assuming red is bad. I press Escape. Now I'm just going to make sure that my settings have stuck. Yes, they have. Good. Okay, so the sound levels are set. The next thing to do would be to measure the latency of our sound card. So the latency is the amount of time that, you know, passes between a physical sound actually happening and the Raspberry Pi finding out. So this is like a delay in the sound card, and it works both for input and output. And in practice, what happens is these input and output latencies add together to make your overdubs out of sync with your main loop. And so the only way to correct for this is if you know the latency ahead of time, then you can actually compensate in terms of the overdub. And so we need to find the latency value. And since this varies from one sound card to the other, the best way to do this is to actually measure it. And what I'm going to do that, is I'm going to run this script called latency.py, like that. And what it's telling me is make sure any hardware monitoring is turned off and hold speaker and microphone close together. Essentially, all this means is that the speaker output needs to be feeding in to the microphone input. And what it's going to do is it's going to play a click out of the speaker, and it's going to listen through the microphone and see, you know, how many milliseconds later it actually receives that click. So it says, when ready, press Enter. I'm going to go ahead and do that. And now it's played the click, it's listened back for it, and it has found a measured latency of about 23 milliseconds. I'm going to say, yep, go ahead and write that to the settings file. And it's going to do that. And now the latency should be fixed. Finally, I'm going to do a last thing that is essentially entirely optional. I'm going to say Raspberry, I'm going to say sudo raspberry config, like this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to system options, I'm going to go to boot/auto login, and I'm going to select console auto login so that it doesn't open the GUI, because loading the GUI takes time and slows down the boot process. And obviously we don't need the GUI in this application. So I'm going to say OK. And yeah, and that's it. So I'll go ahead, finish. Yes, I'm going to reboot now and going to go do some looping. Cheers.